Peggy. Peggy Harkins just came in, she's in the back. Look at her, she's looking this way. I don't see her. She's got a kind of black and gold. You can see her right there, right? She's looking somebody right there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's Larry, that's the son that went to school with Claire. What's his name? Larry Carpenter. Oh, there's him.
Peggy Harkins?
Yeah, we have it.
Oh, sadly, North. That's the platinum.
Oh, there you go. Oh, thank you.
Larry is turning into the whole message.
Yes. She's her mother's best friend.
Is she really? She's the one I talked to when I called her insurance agency.
Yeah, they don't work for Kevin. Yeah, Larry's retired from
Airlines.
Airlines.
Do you think my kind of looks like maybe a blonde freaky guy?
Well, I, you know, I'm
Hey, she's good, huh?
Yeah, very nice. How am I gonna get down there? I guess I could hang on to the
phone. Okay, go
ahead. Okay.
So if I don't have anything to open this arm, I would go sit right there if I were you.
Oh, good idea.
Just go down.
Okay. That's a good idea, then I'll be after the reading.
Mm-hmm. Are you going up with the readers?
No, I don't want, I mean, it's safe.
No, and what we do at the same stand class is if you're going to send a response, the reader comes down and I go up and bow and then they sit down and I go up.
Oh, I'm not going to, I don't know.
But with the reader, is there only one reading and then a response in the gospel or are there two?
There's one reading.
I should have come down.
I should have come down. Maybe it's not too late, I'll go down.
If you would like to sing along, there are hymnals in the back, and the program does have the numbers indicated.
I
Please rise. Good morning. Please rise.
Gathered today in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we come here, we go back to the beginning of Ryan's life as a child of God. We believe in the waters of baptism that Ryan has already died to the things of this world and through death has now risen to be made whole with his God, and that he may now share in God's eternal glory. We place his remains, his earthly remains, on a white cloth, a memory of the white garment given to him at baptism. And we remember how, through his baptism, God promised him a life beyond this one, eternal life in eternal joy. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Ryan, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Though I should wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Your rod and your staff, my comfort and my home.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you on the word of the Lord that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, if even if he dies, will live.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When he saw the crowds, Jesus went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him, and he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. And blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. That has always been one of my favorite readings, especially at a time like this for somebody like Ryan. As somebody who his family described had larger than life experiences and feelings, and I'm just grateful at this point that my parents never met his parents. Did you read the back of the story of the car ending up in the ditch? And they put a sign on the back, "I'm grounded"? It would have been very bad for me if the Colemans had known the O'Briens. You were very creative. And in that creativity came the challenges, the things that didn't make sense in this world. And I'd love to tell you I have this great answer for you that will make sense of everything. I don't. I can't fix the pain that this community and the family are feeling. I can do something. We go back to that first reading, and with our faith, we believe the souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. And what does that mean? People say, well, if people do something like Ryan did, how can they be with God? How could God not love somebody that lived as Ryan lived? How could God not finally look at Ryan and say, "Welcome. All your torments are over. All your challenges are over. You now live in my love." We can't judge anybody, but especially at a time like this, we have to realize that God's love is beyond anything that we can imagine, and that if my God is anything of what I imagine him to be, Ryan is sitting there with God praying for us, that we can know peace. And then that grief that we feel that he never would have imagined will be turned into hope. Because our faith tells us that one day, if we live as we're supposed to live, we'll be with God and we'll be reunited at God's table. And we'll be in that joy of heaven, which is beyond anything that we can comprehend in this life. But for now, we keep the good memories of Ryan alive. I'm never going to forget. I wish I'd seen the, do you have pictures of the car in the ditch? I'd really like to see one of those one day and see that. And remember all the goofy little things, the fun things, the joyful things, the things that you loved. And let that love transform the grief into that hope. Because one thing Ryan knows is how little time we all have left here. As in the sense of eternity, the time we have on this earth is minimal. And so God knows we'll be together again. I'm sure he wants to see a few tears to note these missed. But what do you think he wants the most? He wants people to get everything they can out of this life. He wants people to realize you don't have... what you have there is precious. He knows that better than most. and wants each of us to get the most out of the life we have here, the life that God has given us. So as we pray, we give the grief to God. When the bread and the wine come up and are placed on the altar, we place the grief there and we let God transform it. Because when we come up, whether we receive communion or we get a blessing, we're transformed. We take that grief back, transformed into hope each time that we come to this place, and we offer that to God. And at the time that the grief seems too much to handle, we say, God, you have to take this. This is more than what I can handle in this life. And we just hand it over. It's hard. And we go back to the scriptures that we picked, that they picked, and especially that second reading that talks about the promise that God has made to us. And we remember that hope, that promise that through our baptisms we might know life eternal, and that through our baptism we are God's children. And the grief that Ryan's parents feel, his family feels for his loss, is that same pain that our God feels for us as he wants us all back at that heavenly table. And it's from that comes our hope. And that hope is what will eventually heal the grief and the pain that we feel in this place. Please stand for the intercessions. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
The response is, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
In baptism, Ryan received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Our brother Ryan was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families, including Jean and Horace Theobald, Marion Coleman, and Blakely Coleman, have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all those whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. The family and friends of Ryan seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Ryan. Strengthen our hopes so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, from the voices of your peoples whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die.
Be not afraid.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ryan, we ask your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may have found him to be a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyr, Saint Pius X, Saint Ryan, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, our bishop, Mike and Gary's auxiliaries, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Ryan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those that have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now can dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Don't be nice to him. He just has to take care of you when you're old.
Thank you.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Please kneel. The Catholic Church, we believe present in the bread and the wine, Jesus' presence, body, blood, soul, and divinity. So if you are prepared to receive today, please come forward as usual. But at this time, if you'd like to come up and give your last remains, your last respects to Ryan's earthly remains, just come up with your arms crossed like this, and Susie or I will give you a blessing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, that our brother Ryan may have come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. the end of this celebration doesn't really happen until Ryan's earthly remains get to his final resting place. The reason for that is so that we can remember and that place is remained sacred, not that because Ryan is there, but because out of respect for the life that he led while he was here. And as short as it was, extremely short, there were blessings. Look at the number of people that were touched by that life that are here. And although short, it needs to be honored, remembered, and loved. And our prayers need to remain with the family. We go back to one of the most ancient traditions of society, incense. Everybody thinks it goes back to the early church. Well, it goes long before that. It had a very practical purpose. When people gathered in large rooms before deodorant and showers, that's it. The incense was to help give that sense. When you go into an old church before HEPA filters and everything else, an old stone church, what do you smell?
Incense.
The years and years of incense. So whenever you smell incense, we can remember all those that have gone before us in faith and remember that they're with God. So before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our brother Ryan. May our farewell express our love and affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope that one day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
May choirs of angels lead you into paradise, and may the martyrs come to welcome you, to bring you home into the holy city, so you may dwell
After these final prayers, the servers and I will leave the front part of the church and hand it over to the family who's going to have some. So the live stream will remain running, but in order for the musicians that, I don't know if they're staying or not, and for the servers to be able to continue, we'll conclude the part of Mass and then continue. So as soon as I get to the back and the singing's done, please sit back down. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Ryan in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, that he has risen with him. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed on him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen.
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 Awake from your slumber. Huh?
Good morning. Thank you all for being here today. Ryan really would have loved to see this crowd here to honor him. I think I know most of the room. I'm Ryan's older sister, Katie. And I met Ryan at a Holiday Inn in South Carolina in the 80s. That's true. I was there for the indoor swimming pool. So the whole little brother thing was kind of a sideshow. But of course, once I met him and saw his little dimples and his curls, we were bonded forever. Ryan loved his family more than anything, and he always wanted to make us proud. As a child, Ryan absolutely could not say the word sausage. Try as hard as he did, it always came out sausages. One summer when he knew I was going to be coming home, he practiced over and over and over until he was sure he had it down. And when I arrived, he was already asleep, but I went into his room to give him a hug. And as I did, I leaned down and I felt his hot little breath on my cheek, and he said, "Sausage." Ryan had a lot of self-confidence, to put it mildly. He usually knew more than you about whatever it was. His wife, Kaylee, last week shared a video of him mansplaining a shower curtain to her. Once as a kid, Claire wanted to get out of her car seat, and my dad, trying to reason with a three-year-old, told her, "Claire, if you get out of the car seat and we have an accident, you're gonna go through the windshield and you might be gone." And Ryan said, as a five-year-old coming in with the actual facts, "Nuh-uh, Dad, she'll be an angel, duh." Over the past few weeks, I've often thought he might say to us, "Don't be sad, guys, I'm an angel, duh." Ryan and Claire had a really special relationship. Like many siblings, they tortured each other, but they loved each other deeply. In middle school, Ryan got a basketball autographed by Avery Johnson. Those of you who know Ryan know how much he loved the Spurs, and Avery Johnson was a Spurs player at the time. Ryan carefully put it in a Lucite display case in his room. One day, Claire went looking for something to turn into a terrarium, and so she took the lid off the case and replaced the basketball with dirt and grass and turtles, a box turtle. And now, since the autographed ball was out of the box, for good measure to make sure that it was kept safe, she also took a permanent marker and wrote "Coleman" in all caps right below Avery Johnson's signature. Ryan brought this up regularly for the next 20-ish years. Ryan had endless potential, as you all know. He was smart, good-looking, and personable, and he knew it. He was famous in our family for his personal boasting. That's a phrase Claire termed after a 10-hour car ride with Ryan. We teased him, but we were truly, truly proud of what he had accomplished in his life and the person he was working to become. Ryan put intense pressure on himself, and he didn't always cope with setbacks in a healthy way. In recent years, he needed a lot of support, as we all do at times, but his mother, Susan, and his wife, Kaylee, were the ones who he turned to for comfort. And they worked hard to be there for him, even when he pushed them away. Ryan felt everything vividly. He loved intensely, and he hurt intensely, and he loved no one more than Kaylee and Susan. Losing Ryan is something that can't be undone, and it will be part of our family story forever. Some days it's hard to see a path forward. I was looking for an uplifting quote from Greg Popovich, Pop, the longtime coach of the Spurs, and true to form for Pop, I did not find that, but instead, I found where he once said to a reporter, "I don't even understand the word happy. Happy's a stupid word. It really is. It makes no sense." And I think we all kind of feel like that, and we will for a little bit. But as our family and friends, we ask that you help keep Ryan part of our lives by talking about him and telling stories about him, sharing photos of him, and remembering him. We want Ryan to be remembered for the sensitive, intelligent, funny person he was, the Ryan we all knew and loved. Here in the halls of St. Pius, cracking jokes, kissing girls under the stairwell, and being mediocre at basketball. We know Ryan is at peace now. Brother Allen said at our home last night, "Ryan's in a better place than we all are," and our family truly believes that. He's no longer fighting with himself and his inner thoughts. I heard a song recently in trying to pick music for the reception that really resonated with me. I Can See Clearly Now by Johnny Nash, and one verse in particular made me think of Ryan. I think I can make it now the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here's that rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. Ryan, we love you, we miss you, and we know the sun is shining on you. Thank you all for being here. We hope that you'll join us for a celebration of Ryan's life next door in the Family Center.